So with the Miller Cobot system, there are several ways of moving the robot. We're going to start with the free drive. And the free drive is the operator setting the enabler switch and then physically moving the cobot. Now to do this, we have this enabler switch on the back. This is a three-position switch. So if you press halfway down, you'll feel some resistance. That then will allow you to move it. You press all the way in, and it locks the cobot. Okay? So you just press. Most of the force is used to move the cobot is here at the puck, using your other hand to guide the torch. So you can see we have free movement in it. If I press all the way in, you'll see that the brake is set and I can no longer move the cobot. Right. Okay. And that's all there is. Another way of moving the cobot, if we come to the pendant, we're pressing the move screen, we get our move screen, and we have position control and orientational control. Position control. This, we have my plus and minus. We have it where we can go to the side. And we have up and down. For orientation, have okay, and we can then rotate about. Now, if you're using the move screen, this is where our robot speed, where we can use that. So we can take this down to, say, 20%. And you can move that. For those cases where you want to use the move screen, you have this ability to control the speed, control the orientation, and the position. Let's take that back up to 100. Back. Put it up. And that is moving the cobot with the move screen.
So let's take a look at the AccuGuide for the Miller Copilot. The AccuGuide allows for fine-tuning of the arm position. And it has a world movement, and the world movement is an XYZ coordinate system. So we can press forward, press backwards. We can go on the Y axis, which is go side to side. And then we have a Z coordinate that goes up and down. The AccuGuide allows for yaw pitch and roll as well. So pitch, this rotates the torch about the Y axis. And we're going to use this to adjust the work angle. The roll rotates the torch about the X axis. And if we want to adjust the push and drag angle of the weld, we have the yaw, which rotates the torch about the Z axis. So when it's time to go into the joints, I can push forward. It allows me to tap. Change the work angle, and now as you can see, I have a, I'm able to fine-tune the position of that weld using the Copilot AccuGuide.